Okay.
Can you find someone?
Kennt man
die Tasche hier?
Letter?
Nee, beim.
Komm und die Letter.
Beim
the video, which we agreed. And I've seen how effective it had been because the BTS had recently many improvements. And I said, hey, why not a similar improvement to the BTS? I need people to help me, so I decided, okay, let's present the BTS to the Debian developers. So that's why I'm giving this talk today. So I won't say much about the user side of the BTS, but more about how it's written, how it works, where it runs, and how you can help. So, let's start. So, which? Yeah, I will have one slide explaining what it does, but you all know it, I think. You all used it at least once. Another second introductory slide to tell you where the source are. I didn't expect we had a sufficient room for the talk, so I thought that you could download the source directly, but just you will do later. Then we don't have too much time for the talk, so I will just give basic ideas of which script is used and how it's written, where it is, and so. Basically, the BTS has two parts. First one is the main one, which has been written first, and we have later I added the web interface, which is the most visible part of the BTS nowadays. For each part, I will give some nice features and things that which are really lacking, and which I'd like to have some help with, because I really love this time. Don't hesitate to ask questions in the middle of the talk if you have any. That's what it does, and you know what you think about it. BTS is used to follow the lifework package from the beginning to the end. You can see who does what when the maintainer deploys, you get a mail. When a new bug comes, you get all the copy of the discussions, and you can select what you want to receive, so on. The web interface also shows the list of problems and things to do when the package is listed in the working prospective package written, when it has a critical bug written, when it doesn't meet with the latest standard version. For the price version written, and so on. Alright, the URL, you know, all know is package.create.debian.org. Some figures, it's very much used nowadays, so almost a third or half of our source package have subscribers within the BTS. And it's almost 6,300 subscriptions with 3,000 unique emails. Many people are using BTS to follow what's happening with Debian. Even if they're not regular contributors, they could be. And, for me, it's a starting point when we bring the information from the intern to external people, it's a way to attract new contributors. It's quite big too in terms of HTML pages. Very similar to the very old BTS because it's all static HTML which gets regenerated regularly with a bit of made file like trickery to avoid updating what doesn't need to be updated. So the sources, they are still in the CBS server, so here you have the admin access, if you come on. It's in the QA CS route, and we have a PTS directory as well.
Nothing complicated to remember.
Yeah, the live version is currently running in master.dbn.org. Maybe we move it soon, but right now it's there. It has been there for historical reasons, because the BTS was there at first, and since the BTS was basically a relay made from the BTS, I decided it was hosting to have boxes the same term. But since then the BTS went away before, and I stayed here. I have to live with Woody right now. But it works. I don't have many dependencies here. I don't know if master is restricted or
not. No, master, master is master.
It's always open to our developers.
It's open, to the people who don't have a Debian account but another account with Debian Ada. There's still a summer left of stuff.
It's Merkle is only available.
Merkle is also open. Merkle is public.
It's
a public mill of Score and the better FTP master and the Fax master. Jack is restricted, yes.
Yeah. But you keep fewer people have access.
QA is moved to Merkle. Well, that's easy
because Jack is
restricted.
Yeah. So, I'll first start with the main part. So, when you go into PTS sources, you'll find the closed directories. Because that's where I start. So, the bin directories is full of bell scripting. So very easy, 300 line of code. I don't know if you like Perl or prefer Python. Anyway, it would be nice to see that the main part is done in Perl and the web part is done in Python. So, but I decided to try Python with the PTS, so that's why. But I've always been fond of Perl, but I have nothing against Python, so I decided to use it for the job. So, what else? Quick etc directories, nothing in, apart of one file, which is a template for the confirmation mail that you get when you want to subscribe to your PTS. Per directory, you have a few command codes used by all scripts. Basically, it's accessing the database, because we will see we have a simple virtual TV database used for the subscription. In main, we have a few .forward files for XDIM, so that we have the write script at the good main. And in the www directory, so the whole web interface, and separate sites for .forward. We have two databases. One is subscription TV, it's simple. You have a package as key and a list of emails as value. And the other one is tags TV. This one is indicating which tags you subscribe to, because you can select what you want to receive. Each mail coming in is tagged with a keyword, either BTS, BTS-control, or I think it did a progression trigger. Upload, so you get Cathy's mails. CVS, if the project is configured to send the CVS commits or event commits through the BTS, and so on. They have a few keywords that they never used, but they wanted to make use of them, and that will be the what's left to do, which I mean it's quite vague. So the first script is dispatch. It's the one which receiving all mails to anything at packages.ua.debian.org except the control thing. So it doesn't do anything. Check for spam a bit with promises, spam as well. And after that, it checks headers to see where the mail comes from, if it comes from Cathy, and if that gives a keyword, and it looks up to the database who should receive the mail. Right now it sent mail, it puts mail, but I will disable that soon, hopefully, in order to implement EERP for treating wounds, because I get all wounds and I get all. Well, that's it about this script. Control.pl is the one doing the words when you want to subscribe, you send a mail to pts.qa.debian.org, which is redirected to underline control at packages.qa. Then comes to this script. So nothing complicated. I guess passes the mail, checks the subscribe count and send confirmations, store confirmations in a directory, or rather keys waiting to be configured. The pool directory is used to keep the keys associated to the commands that need to be confirmed. And I also have a few scripts just to look up what's in the database, because it can be handy when you have to check who is subscribed to which package and to remove invalid email. Comp.pl is just creating some statistics about subscribing so that you can make it larger before. So what I like in the mail part is that mail are classified, so we can tell our users if they are only interested to know when new package comes out, they can subscribe to that specific information, and they can be early successors without being bothered with the bugs and the rest. On the contrary, we have the possibility to have a few users subscribing only to bugs because they are interested in that information. And of course, it opens the possibility, it gives us the possibility to send new information without sending it to everyone. Of course, it's quite easy to filter the mail coming from the PTS, where we have specific headers added. So I get all PTS mails in a separate folder. It's about we can always send new info in time using a new keyword. So what's lacking? First important thing for me is some kind of automatic code handling, because I get several dozens of codes daily, and it's boring. So, actually someone tried to implement something which got stored in the middle. So, it must not be so complicated, but it's always tricky to decide on which criteria at which point we decide to remove someone, because I get many bounds due to spam, because I'm forwarding spam coming from the PTS, and mail get bounced, and I don't want to remove someone because it's refusing spam, but
why not?
I do it regularly when I'm fed up, but I think anybody who subscribes to BTS should know that mails forward from master are not original from master. I never bounce a mail back to master.
Yeah. But many do.
So that's why I thought that we should have a kind of statistics system. So if you want only one mail out of two, you can keep him. But that's the tricky part to implement. If you want all mails, you know there's a problem, so remove it.
We have. Yeah. Somehow the PTS mail forwarder is something like a mailing list. Well, a special, but it's a mailing list style. And we have two different names, software for all people in Debian. That's the smart list thing, which nobody wants to touch. And it's the enemies of Carlotta.
Oh, we have Pascal Akin.
Yeah. It's not even a smart list.
You know he's opinion about smart list. So, yeah, and they have this enemies in production, also unable to go for the bug subscriptions. So my question is, wouldn't it perhaps make sense to use, for example, the new enemies of Carlotta also for that, which has some bounce handling and work perhaps work close together with the list masks to say
to
yeah,
make
easier.
I might have to speak with Pascal about that.
Do we implement SPF
in my sphere?
No, of course not.
Why, of course?
Because
SPF sucks.
Because we had like 4 flamewars on that level.
I'm not talking about checking SPF, I'm talking about putting SPF data in Debian domain.
Well, I would say we can now discuss about separate sentences, the talk won't go about anything else, but if you want, we can make a nice discussion about set after barbecue by barbecuing.
Right.
Right.
No,
you buy.
Maybe it's everyone has their own idea about what should be done, what is not acceptable. But that's not the discussion. Let's continue about the PTS. So another nice thing that I really like to do is actually forwarding everything which is on the web pages through mails, having a kind of summary mail sent monthly or once per quarter or something like that, telling, hey, because main maintainers are not looking at the PTS. PTS is much appreciated, but more by user and by QA members than by maintainers, because recently discussed it yesterday with Samuel, who is maintaining a FortiSource package, and he can't make use of that because he doesn't have time to look at 40 different web pages, and even with the script from Igor or QA or Dylan. But if we can push this information to him, it might help. So yes, I'd like to have something which does statistics, like how many bugs were fixed in the last quarter, and how many were opened, and who has them. I don't know, maybe even the SVN stat or TVS stat or project which has that, which could be forwarded to just to make people happy to see that we noticed that they did work, and happy to encourage them to continue and to, even if they want to compete together to get more bugs fixed, that's fine. But something like that would be nice. But there's nothing about this. But since the beginning, I have the keyword visit. The keyword exists since the beginning. It's called summary. Oh, everyone is subscribed by default to this keyword, but nothing is sent to this keyword. So, we're going now. Question about the main part? So, I'm going to speak a bit about the web part. So, that's the usual look of the web pages. We have many information available, last changes, links to LinkedIn, PubCon, Wiki, and Changer. Bugs, of course. And on good package, there's nothing on the top. On bad package, you have many red lights. You don't follow the latest policy. You have release critical bugs. You have or warning like this package is offered, it's looking for a new maintainer, that kind of stuff. I really meant it to be a kind of to-do list for the maintainer or for the contributors are on the page. But not everything is there, and we can add more info still. Just a quick note, I will come back to it later. But how many of you know that you can add information there without doing a deep probe? Yourself? Without doing a deep probe. Just by sending a mail, you can add a new line, for example. Beta packages are available on this site or need help for this. Not many really. It's not a lot. It's the beginning in the developer reference, but it's kind of it's useful. I mean, for example, for the CD package, I have a static. We have static news on the top. You can add static news. So So for example, adding to the CVS repository or to the upstream web page or things like that.
Can you also modify that information?
No. No, that's the bad part.
So
no, it's just really all this stuff is just email converted with image on ARC, and it's stored. This one you have the 30 last mails, and the static news is forever. But of course we can improve that part. But that's why I'm explaining.
I guess no one uses it because you can't remove it anymore. In your announcement, I think it was about 1 or 2 years ago, you said you can't remove it, and I said, okay, I won't use it.
Okay. So, again, a bit overview in the what is the directory. Again, another Python directory is Python script this time. I think the web part is more complex, that's why we have more lines of code, not because Python is more verbose, but yeah, we have a lot of script because really the web part is gathering data from everywhere and putting it together. So it's not complicated code, but a bit more. So another directory is incoming, it's where we store data that we download. It simplifies like package files like bugs, statistics, like progress, excuses. After that, we have a base directory, which is really the kind of database, but only with XML file and emails, simple text emails. After that, we have a style sheet, the XSLT style sheet, which is used to convert all the XML files in HTML file. And yeah, so HTML files are stored in the web directory. Which is good. We have two CGI, that's for only handling errors, because you get redirected to the redirection from the source package to exact HTML page, and it happens regularly that you do use the binary name of the binary package instead of the source package, so they implemented this trick to redirect it nevertheless the good page. A little API for the image on ARC stuff, which is doing the image. So how it works, simple shell script to download everything, just wget many rules, keeping a copy in incoming. After that, we have several scripts, sources to XML, excuses to XML tools, other to XML, which are generating some XML files in the base directory. After that, we have the base directory. Here we add some mails, all the mails coming from the upload for yourself too, when you want to add those static news or base news are coming in. And they are added in the base directory. And after that, we have generate HTML, which is just intelligent call to XSLT proc to convert the XML to HTML. So the script, I have a script bin to all, which is in all of the red script, and it's launched 3 times a day. The run is quite long, I think it takes half an hour or something like that, because with 7,000 source packages, it's that's it.
One question. Yeah. The incoming directory is for detecting new uploads or?
Basically, no.
Okay.
No, it's only it's nothing to do with the incoming window for. So it's not the incoming
of
my master. It's my own incoming where I copy raw data and changes file and summary files provided by other subparts. For example, BTS statistics or list of patch from Ubuntu or things like that. I explained some nice feature before, but you can send you the help news on the stuff to email. And you should use the pseudo pack or pseudo-needed package here, like in the BTS when you submit, but to get it to the right web page, of course. And that's it. But I documented everything from the BTS in the developer reference at that time because I was also working on the developer reference when I wrote the BTS. So everything is documented for readers. Now what can we do more with the BTS? Like, as I told you, it's really going to be a to-do list and things to do. We can always find new things to do for maintainers, so not a problem, but one of the first things that I'm thinking about is adding depth tags information. I mean, depth tags is apparently getting mature enough to be able to be used, so it would be nice to have a line like your package doesn't have any tags yet. Can you add some, if you want to do that, just click here. And then go to the web interface allowing people to contribute new tags. That would be nice, I think. I tried twice already, but they told me, we're changing a lot currently, it's maybe not in time for mainstream yet, but I think it's time.
When did you ask them?
A month ago, something like that.
So you are on FTP master, digging all those package files now.
Yeah.
So I think that anything that's a package file is major enough.
That's why, I mean, we're pushing in that direction with this change, and so there's no reason to not go mainstream completely. Another idea I had recently, which was quite easy to implement, was adding the availability of Ubuntu patches. And Joey told me, oh, I don't care about Ubuntu patches, but Debian patches, which are the BTS, would be nice. So let's do it. So I added that at the same time. Okay. So now you have a warning. You know, you have 5 patches in your BTS. You should really look them up and maybe do something.
Possible to, even if say tech patch, to let's say use that tags to say no, they're not useful.
Then
remove the patch tag.
Patch tag means there's an explanation of the BTS and the backend system that we should call tag and then apply the package. So if it says it's a case, remove the patch.
Yeah, so the worst package is actually dpkg. It has about 50 bugs with patches, and I mean, so we have a bit of work to go through them. But, well, okay, that's left. So, just a conclusion. In 4 years, BTS become an important part of our infrastructure, and it's basically running on my shoulders, and since this year, I've been on JRun. I'm on time too.
I was searching for it.
And I would like to have some help and new people contribute some time. Just in case I'm busy and during 1 or 2 months and we have some new bugs, if you can come on other shoulders too, it would be nice. So that's it.
I applied once a bit the time ago to contribute a bit to the PTS, but one of my problems was actually everything runs with your user ID, which makes me didn't make it quite hard for me to add something to it. So what I really would like is to move it to the QA user. We have the QA user for that reason.
It's done.
Okay, when I last looked, very good. Because that's really important. So we more quickly work on it.
Oh, you can still commit to the CVS and then I can do a CVS update. No, it's done. We moved to the QA user on last one.
Okay.
So you can do sudo QA and do stuff. But, yeah?
I have a small wish list. That is that mail that is sent to package at packages.qa.debian.org could be sent to the maintainer too, so that we can move from using the spam trap packages.debian.org to move to use QA. You know what I mean? Sorry, I'm still. Yeah, the default tag. I mean, I think it'd be nice if the mail under the default tag, which is, for example, mail regarding a transition or something like that, could be sent to the maintainer as well.
Yeah,
because in that case, I don't have people don't have to mail the both addresses, and in sort of a way, mail sent there won't have spam. So the maintainer, perhaps someday we can stop.
Yeah, so problem spam is a big problem.
Yeah, but
right now you can't send any matches to GTS. You get a bounce.
Yeah, but
unless you add the good
color.
I know not everyone likes this.
The other solution it was would be to forward the mail that goes to packages package at packages.debian.org to the PTS.
Okay.
So yeah. Not instead just sending it to the maintainer,
sending it to
the PTS. The problem is that you rightfully mentioned that packages.debian.org has currently no spam filter at all, but that should be.
I think my point is that we should to solve the spam problem to require the header that currently the PTS is requiring.
Yeah, but I don't think it's a good idea to make it required to add this header. Just if you want to send a mail to the maintainer, or no?
Well, I think that we need an open management solution. Never work with something else.
You should implement spam filters on the machine which is receiving packages debian.org, and then when it forwards mail to the PTS, it can add the right header.
Right, you should not forward mail just blindly adding the header, because that will result in lots of spam for subscribers.
Where is the spam in the master?
Yeah.
Do the mails going to packages QA.org get forwarded to both the maintainer field and also the uploaders?
No.
Only
to subscribers.
Yes, subscriber only. Oh. So I'm subscribed to no more packages, for example.
Right, but many people don't do that.
Well, because I started writing to package when I wasn't speaking at the time.
So you're just too lazy to unsubscribe by the end.
I can start out of the mail, of course, no?
So the main thing.
What about having a PTS version control to packages? Packages or QA?
That was my original plan. Someone told me, what happens when a control package gets created? So it's like, okay, I will use an email which is not possible in a package name, so I use underline control, but it's not very nice for user to
PTS.
So
control.
So,
PTS dash control.
But we have PTS at qa.debian.org already. That's
not PTS control.
It's not the same domain. That's why it's
talking about you can have a way to interact with adding new news, erasing news. Same way as you control in copying that you send the signed mail and then you say remove all my packages, so that you can actually interact with the static headers that you can understand. So we can do that with signed mails.
Oh, you can do that. But the email name has nothing to. But the email address has nothing.
Yeah,
to
but I'm talking about a control mechanism to modify information in the QA.
Well, actually, experience on the PTS has shown that the number of people who really abuse features is very, very low. Yeah. And so even if you just would remove the static news, it would send mail to the maintainer, the subscriber says, this thing has been removed. It would be enough because if really someone starts to abuse it, you can still kill him. Just not the leaks information, but just the mass information as they eat it.
No, I'm talking about signing for only one reason, that if not, we might start getting spam there.
Also, that was the moving page.
Yeah, I mean, on the static page, some people might start sending spam there, and then all the spam will be...
No. You use just an additional header, but it has one reason why I don't like it, all the signed stuff. Because I'm sometimes working in places I don't have a cheat key available. The other thing that makes it harder for me to work there means I won't use it anywhere. But it has proposals to even buy a signed place for BTS access. But that would mean that I can't use BTS as much as I do now. So I'm really against using forcing people to sign mail, unless it's really hard necessary. Which means
it's not a real problem, since when you want to add information, you have to use an email to tell which package you want. So it's spam doesn't put it here. And for removing, if you create comments to send, spam will also not use the good comments. I mean,
shouldn't be a problem.
I will create a control way of doing that, managing that information.
Control bot like BTS control bot with a complicated syntax which nobody understands and spammers will not use. I mean, if it's requiring like a header and some command at the beginning of the line, no spammer will ever use it. It's too complicated.
Yeah,
but if someone really starts to do it, you can simply clean it manually or require a signed name.
Something that's when you work with package, if I understand it right, package QA does that mail back if the keyboard is not set up. Wouldn't it be possible to check that during the interface? Because in that way, it's just the produce back scatter, which is, I don't think, not the best thing to do.
Yeah, for spamming, it's definitely...
If you check your data, and the turn your mail is not acceptable for us, you won't build the back scatter. But if you accept the mail, send it back later.
Could we stop discussing about spam?
That was not spam.
Okay, another question. What's the reason for this effect that the first upload isn't noted in the PTS? That the changes mail for the first upload is never shown or is never stored? I think so.
It was a tricky reason. I mean, there could be a kind of denial of service if you spam with many fake accepted messages, and you can create thousands of directories for a non-existent source package. Mm-hmm. So I wait until the package is officially accepted by the FTP masters, and before I decide to cut the mail online. First mail comes before the new package files, I don't get this one.
I can give you a file which I already produced with new packages, which is updated every 2 hours. You can simply sync that from FTPmaster Debian.org. Or just you can look there for new packages.
Just keep the mail, and for big package doesn't appear in the cloud. So we don't use anything.
I think for 2 days already.
It's
nice to see you have so many ideas. You have so many sketches that they
don't. You can sync that file, you have a timestamp in front of it, it's package name.
Yeah, should be nice. You just store mail for like 6 hours, wait until you get this packages, and if the packages in there, you can simply discard the mail or else it creates a new directory and add the information. Now do it.
So it's a block. I think we should finish this. This is much. So it's interesting. That's just one last question. So
could you add a page with BTS developer information? How you can get access to the CPS?
Cargo, or where do you expect that to be, on the wiki or on the...
No, no, just separate page.
Are there on the...
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure. In which way would that make sense?
You mean to be just like...
I didn't understand your question.
Same as we had for...
On the front page.
How can you help?
Yeah.
How
okay.
do you get access?
Yeah, okay.
Who
so,
was?
The front page identity is only a feed to type
yes.
of the package. Thanks for all. As a listener, we have other interesting thoughts. So we can always discuss later, but as a listener, so this looks like we should finish this talk now.
I think it's worth to discuss that with Maxi, discuss that directly with him, and we should.
Can we talk later a bit about this?
Yeah.
What's
the next talk?
I think it's Peter.
Okay.
I'll
take 5 minutes. Yeah, 5 minutes.